My group here at Princeton University studies sustainable engineering materials, and we specifically concentrate on sustainable types of concrete. Around the world, traditional concrete is used in vast quantities. It's the second most used resource after water on a volume basis. But unfortunately, this manufacturing process for the cement powder releases about 1 tonne of carbon dioxide per 1 tonne of cement. We're moving away from Portland cement powder, which is used to make cement paste. And instead, we're looking at alternatives where instead of using cement powder, we use industrial byproducts. There's a couple of types of byproducts. There's fly ash that comes from coal power plants. There's also ground granulated blast furnace slag. That is a byproduct that comes from when you convert iron ore into cast iron. We also use clays. In the alternative concretes that we're looking at, the glue that holds it together is based on activated slag and fly ash. We use alkali activation, and this produces a very similar binder material that holds the concrete together. Any situation that uses concrete will be able to use alkali activated based concrete, whether it's in bridges, in roads, in skyscrapers, houses, pavements. It's quite a versatile material. So we're analysing a whole lot of different properties to do with these materials. With these samples, we're going to be analysing the atomic structural changes that occur during drying. So my group is investigating the durability of these alkali activated materials. One type of degradation that we've been investigating is called microcracking. Microcracking is a process where the paste is exposed to drying conditions that causes the surface to crack. Microcracking is bad because it opens up highways within the sample that allow chemicals to get in very easily and degrade the material. We've found that by adding a really small amount of nanoparticles, such as zinc oxide, we can reduce the extent of microcracking. In terms of the societal benefits, alkali-activated materials are known to be able to reduce CO2 emissions. Cement production accounts for 5 to 8% of man-made CO2 emissions. If we can reduce those emissions by up to 80%, we're going to have a significant impact on CO2 emissions around the world.